This is Getting On With Life, Pastoral Wisdom for Successful Christian Living. I'm Chris Field, and this title is How You Fooled Yourself. Your emotional state affects how you remember and understand things. Your emotions filter information and activate one set of memories or impressions over another. It is therefore important to understand what is going on and to take charge of your emotions, rather than letting them rule you and fool you. In simple terms, our feelings tend to sit in one of three positions. Most people are most often emotionally neutral, just getting on with life as it comes along. On some occasions, we can feel very happy and upbeat about life. These feelings might be prompted by succeeding at something or experiencing some emotionally uplifting experience. On other occasions, though, we can feel quite down and even depressed. These feelings might be prompted by an experience of failure or some emotionally challenging experience. Psychologists use the term mania for our positive emotional state and depression for our negative emotional state. Some people fluctuate between their highs and lows so disruptively they are diagnosed as manic depressive or bipolar, as it is commonly labeled today. In our normal frame of mind, not manic and not depressive, we take things as they come. We do not have any particular emotional magnet messing with our interpretation of the information coming to us. If in that state we were to think back on our life, we would have access to all kinds of memories, good and bad, happy and sad. If we are in a manic, upbeat or positive frame of mind, our emotional filter tends to focus on and remember times when we felt this way before. The positive feelings build on the positive feelings, and we can have quite a strong sense of well-being, security and happiness, and even a sense of invincibility, feeling confident that everything is going to go our way. Conversely, if we are in a depressive frame of mind, our emotional filter will tend to focus on and remember times when we felt depressed before. The downcast feelings build on similar downcast feelings, and we can have quite a strong sense of depression, failure, and fear of the future, and even a feeling of hopelessness as if whatever we do is going to turn out badly. Our emotional filter is not actually a bad thing. It's just something we need to understand and manage appropriately. If you are not aware of it, you may end up letting it fool you into wrong thinking. Jesus talked about the ability of our emotions to completely change our memories when he spoke of a woman giving birth. That's from John chapter 16, verse 21. A woman has sorrow when giving birth, because her hour has come. But as soon as the child is delivered, she forgets the anguish for joy that a child is born into the world. During the difficult times of a pregnancy, a woman may have an emotional low and swear she will never go through this again. But after the baby is born, a different set of emotions kick in, and she might feel much more positive about having more children. Her feelings of discomfort and despair are replaced by feelings of joy and delight. This shift in perspective doesn't mean she's mad. It is typical of how all of us function under the influence of our emotional filter. Wise King Solomon recorded his mother's instruction about giving strong drink to those who need to forget their troubles. That's recorded in Proverbs chapter 31, verses 6 and 7. Give strong drink to him who is about to die, and wine to those with heavy hearts. Let him drink and forget his poverty, and remember his misery no more. Certain foods and experiences modify our emotional state. We use these to self-medicate, to make ourselves feel good. We can self-medicate with a cup of coffee in the morning, a home-cooked meal, talking to a friend, listening to favorite music, eating a sweet, or retail therapy. When someone feels happy with a loved one, such as spouse, sibling, parent, or child, that emotional state triggers memories of all the happy times they enjoyed in that relationship. Induced by such feelings, they might say something like, "You are wonderful. You make me so happy." However, when offended by that person, their emotions can switch setting, and suddenly they not only feel negative about the person, but remember many times when they felt negative about them before. So they might say, "You have always been so hurtful. I've never really liked you. I wish I never knew you." On both occasions, the person can speak quite sincerely. For that moment, all the thoughts, memories, and feelings they have access to match what they are saying. Quite often in such an upset, the emotions settle down and the person feels apologetic for their excessive outburst. They may then say something like, "I didn't really mean what I said when I was attacking you." Once again, the person is speaking sincerely. They now review what they said, and they don't have access to all the dominating emotions and memories that fed their negative feelings. They now have a more reasonable view of things, and they try to patch up the relationship. Clearly, it is dangerous to be so out of control emotionally. Not only will we be pushed like a boat in the wind, but others around us will be hurt and confused by our changeableness. We each need to have rule over our own spirit, controlling our emotions, managing our emotional filter so it doesn't fool us and make a mess of our perceptions. Step 1. Realize you have an emotional filter that can fool you into believing things that are not true, because they are skewed, either positively or negatively. Step 2. Recognize your predisposition toward unrealistic upbeat feelings or unrealistic negative feelings, or even to switching from one to the other erratically. Step 3. Ask God to help you get rule over your own spirit, so you don't get pushed around by your emotions or the skewed sense of reality from your emotional filter. Step 4. Get your friends and loved ones to function as a reality filter for you. Find people who are balanced, not overly optimistic or overly negative or critical, and get them to check your ideas with you. Step 5. Wise up about life and reality. A good way to do that is to read the Bible and learn Christ's principles for living. They'll be an anchor for your life and give you a reference point to test whether you are out of balance or not. And may God bless you.